Hey everybody, Adam Savage here with a show and tell from my cave, and as you've probably already gathered, it is space related. This is, of course, my beautiful A7L replica built by Ryan Nagata, on which I did some of my own custom machining on these front couplers. But over the past few months, Ryan has delivered a few augmentations to this suit that truly take it into a whole nother realm of replica. And we're gonna walk through those modifications today because they are so beautiful. All right, let's get started. First up, we should take some nice video shots of how beautiful this suit is. Made of a coated nylon that Ryan chose for the way in which it weathers. You can see some of the close-up seam detailing here, the different stitching. This is Ryan's incredible fidelity. It is a truly amazing replica. Even went so far, Ryan discovered that NASA uses a very specific kind of Velcro that's laid out all in rows instead of randomly like normal Velcro. I guess that's NASA spec. And in fact, there are these, this is a detail I love. There are, the buttons are sewn in. I guess they're mounted to like PTFE or I don't know, some type of plastic and then sewn in. Not having done that, Ryan actually, can you see this? He screen printed the stitches onto the little nubbin that goes around the button. Yeah. And then airbrushed the edge. Like from here, you cannot tell that that's what's happening. That is amazing. Here are the couplers that I machined. This is the project on which I discovered that if you're using 6061 and then perhaps another type of aluminum, that when you anodize them, you will get, I don't know if it's visible on camera, you will get two totally different colors, as I have here. This color is different than this color. This is another thing Ryan did, which I particularly love, is he, to do the internal plug of the electrics. This is just a laser print of the front of one of those connectors.
Yeah, I know.
Totally awesome. All right, let's talk about some of these modifications. The first one is in the hands, and I know when I did the one day build of my new space gloves, I did a bit of a show and tell about the space gloves. These are absolutely amazing. This is the brand newest pattern that Ryan has built for the Apollo era gloves. This pattern was patterned off a real glove, so it is as close as humanly possible to the real thing. And just to show you the fidelity that Ryan goes to, the internal labels are all there, and including there's an internal label inside there. But the thing I wanted you to pay attention to is this. This is no longer a cast piece of plastic. This is a machined and anodized piece of aluminum for the glove wrist ring. And Ryan made a set of receivers for this for my suit. So now the gloves, it's aluminum on aluminum, and there are still magnets that hold it together. It's a very positive fit. Oh, and I gotta tell you, like having aluminum, just, honestly, right? I said this when I machined these, just like having actual aluminum parts on this thing make it feel so much more real, and the weight feels great. I mean, this is, yeah, these things are beautiful. But that is still not what I wanted to show you today. That is still just, we are traveling along the way. The very thing I want to talk about today is Ryan's new neck ring. Now, let me take you on a tour through the old neck ring. This is Ryan's original neck ring that my suit shipped with. And it's beautiful. It's got Velcro around the bottom to attach to the suit. The pieces and the markings are great. He's got decals for the engage and disengage, use with helmet ring only. Also, just to show you this up close. Yeah, I mean, it's beautiful modeling. It looks great. And mine is beat up because I'm hard on my equipment. But I do want to point out that Ryan actually paints metallic paint into the silicone mold to get a really robust coating. And still, I was able to beat the hell out of it. But for me, all that weathering makes it look kind of good. But Ryan's new neck ring is a wholly different beast. Here it is. And it's not just completely machined out of aluminum. But it has, if you can see here, and I'll shoot a close-up of this, little pins, and those little pins actually retract. Oh, yep, check that out. It is a functioning neck ring. Okay, let's talk about functioning. This isn't gonna help you survive in space. That's not what I mean by functioning. I mean that it locks. It locks. What does it lock to? I'm so glad you asked. Because one of the other things that Ryan has improved upon is the bubble helmet. Ugh, oh my gosh, okay, wait, I'll be right back. Here is Ryan's old bubble helmet, and it looks great. It is a beaut. Again, this is the one that shipped with my suit when I first got it. The Selva device here, again, the decals and everything, and it fits in this neck ring. Well, it actually doesn't quite fit in this neck ring, but that's okay, it doesn't have to. It fits in the old neck ring, this one, yes. But a couple of things about the shape of this. Ryan was able to have access to a real bubble helmet, and I think you can see the slightly different shape between these two. This one is way, way, way more accurate. And if you look at certain close-up details, like the little spacers here around, here they're just blank little little oblong pills, but here they have little holes on either side of them, just a little bit more detail. And again, the newest thing about this bubble helmet is not only is it pulled in thicker, this one's pulled in very thin PETG, and I actually left it in my car on a Mythbusters shoot, and it got a little dented because of the heat. Ryan pulled this out of a much thicker piece of PETG. It's still quite thin compared to the real thing, but again, this doesn't have to help you survive in the vacuum of space. But its shape is 100% just gorgeous. And it has a anodized aluminum ring. Now, here's the thing about this ring. This will fit in an original Apollo neck ring. It will actually lock into an original piece of Apollo hardware. That's the kind of fidelity. Look, I pretty much guarantee you, I am never attaching this to a real Apollo neck ring. I don't think anyone's going to allow me to, but I could. Oh, yeah. So, of course, now the thing you're wondering is, this locks to this? Yes, it does. Watch this. And, dude, I can barely contain my excitement. A locking neck ring. Oh, listen to that. Oh, obviously I'm gonna have to put this on, but in order to put it on, I'm gonna actually, it's not quite a build, but it is an elaboration of today's show and tell. So on the lower left red coupler, this one here, I've actually machined a air distribution system on the backside of this for the helmet. Yes, because the helmet is meant to disperse air. It starts here, you push air in through here, and it wraps around the inside of the suit. I'll shoot a B-roll of that in a second. And it comes up this little air conditioning line. See this, I've glued this in and then safety pinned it into the suit, and it comes up here. And this is an accurate part right here. And this feeds in to the back of the helmet. Where? It feeds in here, and then this whole system is a distribution system for air. Check that out, right? So the air comes in here and spins around here, and the whole point is to bring air up and around the inside of the helmet to keep it from fogging over. Yeah. So the air comes in here,
gets pushed around here and spread out all the way around the inside of the helmet. Oh, so beautiful. Hey, so at this moment in the video, you should be watching me put on a spacesuit and try it out with the neck ring so I can get the whole experience. And you know what happened? I was pushing the record button when I thought I was pushing the stop button and vice versa. I'm sure you've done that. I know we have all done that in the past, and I did it for the finale of this video, which is like a 10-minute cut that somehow didn't happen, and I just didn't notice. And Norm called me up, and he was like, hey, we're missing the outro for the neck ring detail. So that's what's about to happen. Enjoy the neck ring finale. All right. Now that we've established all of that, it's time for the moment of truth. I'm gonna put this on, try the neck ring out in situ. I'm also going to be showcasing one other cool mod to this suit that Ryan sent me recently. Oh, you're gonna love it. Oh, all right, let's see here. Oh, okay, so. Too fast, hold on. Here, need out. Now, this is Ryan's beautiful communications assembly, otherwise known as the Snoopy Cap. And the Snoopy Cap here is super, super cool, and I'm about to show you why. Because it's got this, it's got this plug here, and it actually goes to this, accurate plug. Let's see.
And we get a Quindar beep after everything we say. Yeah.
So my.
But wait,
that's not all, Mission Control.
Yeah, there's still a few bugs to work out.
But there's one more thing. How do I breathe in here? With this. Now, because I have attached this, I've got this inflator. Oh my God, this is driving me crazy. Nope. Hold on. Okay. Great. All right, I'm already heating up, so it's time to attach the fan. This is a pool toy inflator I purchased on Amazon for about 25 bucks. It connects up into here. And when I turn it on, when I turn it on, it blows air up back there, which is awesome. Just put that on the ground there. And now, let's put on this helmet, shall we? I need to wear outdoors during the coronavirus outbreak. And as you can see, it's not fogging up my visor. It goes away! Can't tell you how satisfying it is to be able to open this latch and pull off a helmet. That is just feels like such an awesome experience. Thank you guys for joining me for this show and tell. Truth be told, I think I've had more fun with it than you have. Oh, I continue to be amazed by Ryan Nagata's incredible work, and our long-term and long-time collaboration is super fulfilling part of our friendship. Thank you guys for joining me for this show and tell. See you next time.